Hopefully you've all heard about climate change and global warming and rising sea levels. I study corals that started growing shallowly on a reef platform. And that's important because fairly soon after they start growing, they grow high enough that at extreme low tide, their tops get exposed to the air. On a very hot day, at a particularly low tide, the top of the coral, the uppermost 1 centimeter, maybe 2 centimeters, will die. But below that, what we call the highest level of survival, the coral stays alive and it continues to grow out and up until the next extreme low tide. And so from that, we can learn about how much sea level is changing and how fast sea level is changing. We have some sense this is something that we need to anticipate and prepare for. Otherwise, we're going to be dealing with flooding. People are going to lose their homes. People are going to lose their livelihoods when their neighborhoods are underwater during extreme floods. A coral microatoll is a specific shape of a coral. What we see is that for the outermost few rings, they're several centimeters higher, in some cases 5 to 10 centimeters higher than the centers of these corals. So this tells us that in recent decades, sea level has risen by 5 to 10 centimeters to allow these corals to grow higher. We've found coral microatolls at other sites in Singapore. So we're really looking forward to finding out what sea level was doing at each of these sites, and we hope to get to know more in the months ahead.